Schizophrenia is a severe mental illness that affects how a person thinks, feels, and behaves. It literally translates to split mind, alluding to losing touch with reality. Schizophrenia affects approximately 24 million people worldwide, which is roughly 1 in 300 or 0.32% of people. Among adults, the rate is more like 1 in 222 or 0.45%, as the typical age of onset is in the late teens or early adulthood. It is very uncommon to develop symptoms of schizophrenia before the age of 12 or after the age of 40. Scientists are not entirely sure why this is the case, but that it may perhaps be due to a combination of genetics, brain changes, and hormones. The age of onset is slightly earlier for men, late adolescence to early 20s, than for women, which is more early 20s to early 30s. More subtle changes in cognition and social relationships may precede the actual diagnosis, often by years, which is also referred to as the prodromal phase. The occurrence of schizophrenia in men and women is roughly the same, with 0.49% of males over the age of 20 experiencing schizophrenia and 0.42% of females over the age of 20 experiencing schizophrenia. Unfortunately, the vast majority of people with schizophrenia are not receiving mental health care. More than 2 out of 3 people with psychosis in the world do not receive specialist care. Most resources for mental health services are inefficiently spent on care within psychiatric hospitals. There is clear evidence that psychiatric hospitals are not effective in providing the care that people with mental illnesses need. Approximately 50% of people in these psychiatric hospitals have a diagnosis of schizophrenia. These people would likely be far better served in the community if there was adequate funding going toward community supports. Some options for this type of community support include integration in primary health and general hospital care, community mental health centers, day centers, supported housing, and outreach services for home-based support. Financial costs associated with schizophrenia are disproportionately high in relation to other chronic mental health and physical health conditions. This is a reflection of both direct costs of healthcare as well as indirect costs of lost productivity, criminal justice involvement, social service needs, and other factors beyond healthcare. There is plenty of evidence indicating that schizophrenia occurs equally amongst different races, ethnicities, genders, social classes, etc. However, Black patients are 3 to 4 times more likely to be diagnosed with psychotic disorders. This indicates that perhaps there is a degree of racism involved in the diagnostic process. Approximately half of individuals with schizophrenia have co-occurring mental or behavioral health disorders. People with schizophrenia are 2 to 3 times more likely to die early than the general population. This is often due to physical illnesses such as cardiovascular, metabolic, and infectious diseases. Underdetection and undertreatment of these medical conditions in this population is one of the possible reasons for this excess early mortality, in addition to increased rates of these conditions in this population. An estimated 4.9% of people with schizophrenia die by suicide. This rate is far greater than the general population, and the highest risk is in the early stages of the illness. About 20% of people living with schizophrenia will attempt suicide at least once. The estimated average potential life lost for individuals with schizophrenia in the United States is 28.5 years. There is currently no cure for schizophrenia. However, a range of care options for people with schizophrenia exists. It is estimated that at least 1 in 3 people with schizophrenia will experience complete remission of symptoms. Some people with schizophrenia will experience shifting periods of worsening of symptoms with periods of remission of symptoms, while others may experience just kind of a gradual worsening of symptoms over time. If you believe that you or someone you know is experiencing symptoms of schizophrenia, please speak with your doctor. My name is Lauren and I live with schizoaffective disorder. If you'd like to see more videos about this, make sure to subscribe to our channel. And also, if you want to help support us in creating this kind of content, please check out the link to our Patreon page. Thank you so much for watching and wishing you and your loved ones good health. See you in the next video. Bye.